It's time for OTV Top 10.
This is Akanksha, you're listening to OTV Top 10.
And this is Deepti Ranjan. Today is the 14th of December and here are the top news of the day. State Director of Family Welfare Bijay Panigrahi said that those vaccinated against COVID-19 will have defense against the new mutated variant of virus Omicron. The Health Department in Odisha has urged one and all in the state to get vaccinated against COVID-19 at the earliest. The department has also urged social workers to encourage people to get the jabs. Let's hear what Bijay Panigrahi had to say on the matter.
संक्रमण वर्तमान देखा देखादी सो कौ मुहूर्त भी आम राज्य भी संक्रमण संख्या बढ़ी पारे तेणु ता पूर्व आम समस्ते सतर्क रहा उचित सजग रहा उचित आम समस्ते जमी डिसेंबर शेष सुधा टीका नहीं जावा ता प्रति आम निश्चय गुरुत्व देवा ता संगे संगे आम कोविड एप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर जोटा आम कहूँ मास्क पिंधे सामाजिक दूरता रखिए गहली करेंगे ना.
The government said in the Lok Sabha that the agriculture budget has been increased to ₹1,23,000 crore, which earlier used to be around ₹21,000 crore. Responding to a question during the question hour, Minister of States for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Kailash Chaudhary said that the government is incentivizing the farmers under crop diversification scheme and these incentives have also been in horticulture. The government has also increased the minimum support price or MSP of different crops and is committed to increase the income of the farmers. Replying to a question on the crop loss in Andhra Pradesh, the minister also said that the government gives compensation to the farmers if the crops are lost due to natural calamities from National Disaster Response Fund and State Disaster Response Fund.
Manoj Patra, Raigada District Correspondent of Odisha Television Limited, passed away during treatment at MKCG Hospital in Barampur at the age of 55. The late journalist fell sick yesterday and was admitted to the hospital. He breathed his last this morning while undergoing treatment. OTV employees expressed deep grief over the passing away of Manoj Patra, who had a long association with the channel since 2009. The office of BJP National Vice President Baijan Panda, through a tweet, informed that the minister expressed deep grief at the untimely passing away of OTV correspondent from Raigada, Manoj Patra.
Video streaming giant Netflix has announced new and reduced prices for plans in India, with the mobile-only plan now starting at ₹149 per month. Users will now pay ₹149 a month from ₹199 earlier for Netflix Mobile and ₹199 instead of ₹499 for its basic plan for the same period. The standard plan will be charged at ₹499 per month. The most expensive Netflix plan, which is the premium plan, will now cost ₹649 per month. This plan used to cost ₹799 per month earlier.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi, along with Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, ventured out on the streets of Varanasi in the early hours today and visited the just inaugurated Kashi Vishwanath Dham and Banaras Railway Station. In a tweet posted around 1 a.m., Prime Minister Modi said that he inspected key development works in the temple town. Varanasi is Prime Minister's parliamentary constituency since 2014. Earlier on Monday, Prime Minister Modi visited the Kal Bhairav Mandir and inaugurated the first phase of ambitious Kashi Vishwanath Corridor project, being referred to as Kashi Vishwanath Dham.
Scientists at Oxford University, through a study, have concluded that the Omicron variant of COVID-19 is likely to affect fully vaccinated people. The study used blood samples from 28 individuals who had previously received two doses of the Oxford AstraZeneca or Pfizer's BioNTech vaccines and a live virus isolate to explore Omicron's vaccine efficacy. The scientists found substantial decrease in neutralizing titers, a measure of the level of neutralizing antibodies generated in responses to vaccination against or infection from COVID-19. The results indicated that the Omicron variant has the potential to drive a further wave of infections, including among those already vaccinated, although the researchers highlighted that there is currently no evidence of increased potential to cause severe disease, hospitalizations, or death in vaccinated populations.
India's star batter Virat Kohli may skip the forthcoming ODI against South Africa, while injured Rohit Sharma will miss the tests in South Africa, the ODIs after that will see Virat Kohli being unavailable for the Indian team. It is learned that Kohli has already informed the BCCI about his decision. India and South Africa will play 3 ODIs after the tests. The final test of the tour will begin on January 11th with the ODI set to commence from 19th. The ODI squad is yet to be announced for the series.
Indonesia's Meteorology, Climatology and Geophysics Agency informed that a minor tsunami was detected after a massive 7.4 magnitude earthquake jolted Indonesia's East Nusa Tenggara province. While one person was injured in Manggarai district, several houses were damaged in Selayar Island of South Sulawesi province. The quake struck at 10:20 a.m. with the epicenter at 113 km northeast of Larantuka sub-district in East Flores district and the depth at 10 km under the seabed. The earthquake previously triggered a tsunami warning, but it was lifted about 2 hours later. The tremors triggered a minor tsunami as the seawater surface rose by 7 cm in the districts of Nagakeo and Manggarai.
British Prime Minister Boris Johnson described the UK and India as natural partners who are working together for many fantastic projects, from partnership on 5G and telecom startups that will transform people's life and promote the principles of freedom, openness and peace. Addressing the Global Technology Summit via video link, Johnson said that over the coming decade, India and the UK will continue to deepen their bonds on technology and other areas that they have set out in the 2030 India-UK roadmap. The 2030 roadmap for stronger India-UK strategic ties was signed between Johnson and Prime Minister Narendra Modi during the virtual summit in May this year.
Higher prices of commodities, food items and manufactured products lifted India's November wholesale inflation on both sequential and year-on-year basis. Accordingly, the annual rate of inflation based on wholesale prices rose to 14.23% last month from 12.54% in October. Similarly, on a year-on-year basis, the wholesale price index data furnished by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry has risen exponentially over November 2020 when it stood at 2.29%.
That's it for today. For news in detail, visit odissatv.in, Odisha's premier destination for news updates in English. This is Deepti Ranjan, signing off.